हेलो।
यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल सर।
राइट राइट।
वीडियो एट द मोमेंट एंड देन वी कैन स्टार्ट एट 4:05 सर। Sir, kindly hide the video. Thank you.
हेलो।
या सर, यू आर ऑडिबल।
कैन आई स्टार्ट?
नो सर, इन जस्ट 5 मिनट्स फ्रॉम नाउ द
ओके ओके
पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर जॉइनिंग इन।
ओके ओके
या आई विल जस्ट इंट्रोड्यूस यू एंड देन यू कैन स्टार्ट।
ओके ओके
A very good evening to everybody. My name is Shashank Sharma, and on behalf of Scoreme Solutions Private Limited, I would like to welcome you all to this webinar on approach and assessment skills for retail and MSME customers, and also how FinTechs are transforming this industry. Before I start, a quick introduction, on Scoreme Solutions. So we are basically a FinTech company working in the lending space, where we provide financial analysis algorithms with respect to bank statements, GST, ITR, financial statements, online KYCs for the BFSI domain in Milan. So a very warm welcome to all the attendees who are rejoining us on this webinar, and also a very fresh welcome to all the new attendees in this webinar. Now, the topic for today is more, interesting, because it bringing a component of sales, that how we have to take it forward. Although we have been conducting a series of webinars with respect to different aspects of evaluation, with respect to different aspects of what are the new technologies available. So we thought better will be that if we construct, something on how to approach the customer and how to assess the customer as well. Now, to conduct this webinar along with me, so we have a session expert, Mr. Rajesh Mahajan. So basically, Mahajan sir is, retired from Bank of Baroda as a journal manager. And he has over 37 years of banking experience, which, ranges from various assignments into multiple roles. He has also been representing the bank in the Middle East for a span of 3 years. He has headed the corporate branches of the bank for 6 years. Currently, Mr. Mahajan is an industry expert in the rank of associate professor, and he is a visiting faculty to NIBM and other leading training institutes. So before, I take you on, I will just like to explain you the session flow. So we will start with the subject presentation now, and post this, we will have the Q&A round. I would request all of you to post your questions in the Q&A section so that we can address it. As many as questions as possible in this frame, and other questions, we can always get back to you with an email on the answers. So taking this forward, Rajesh sir, I would request if you can just take over and start with the presentation, sir. Rajesh sir, you can start now.
Okay. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, sir.
Welcome to all the participants in this session on approach and assessment skills for retail / MSME customers. During the session, our main focus will be role of direct sale agents or direct marketing agents in bank marketing, what we understand by marketing mix, what are the marketing essentials, what we understand by the customer target group and product target group. So starting with the role of direct sales agent and direct marketing agent in bank marketing, there are specific roles to collect the information about the customer, to create the database with all details so obtained, to create awareness among the customers, to educate them about the system and security aspects as well, to generate reports to accommodate the needs of the customer and management, improve the system to cater the need of the customer, optimum utilization of the available resources to reach effective customer service. In this slide, I want to thrust few points. Whenever you are meeting the customer, it is always desirable from the customer point of view that you are having maximum information about the customer. And you are required to develop an art through which you can ask the question in such a way that question is, the customer is never feeling offended and he is cooperating. Your question should not be direct. For example, in case if you are going to a customer and you want to offer a product which may be suitable more to an age group of 30 to 40, years. So in such a case, instead of straight away asking the age, you just give the leading questions like, sir, in case if I am not wrong, you look very young and maybe around 32. He may be around 38, which you may be knowing. But everybody will be feel very elated in case if you are asking 32. He will definitely say, no, I am 38. So you can start the basically discussions from here. And at the same time, whenever you are approaching the customer, you must never feel that you are doing any obligation to the customer. It is always, even if many a times you will find the attitude of customer may not be very friendly. Okay. Spontaneously, there is no need for any reaction. But keep in mind that there are certain customers which are very irritated. Right? So one has to develop this art of dealing with such a situations also. Second thing, which the code of the conduct for the DSA and the DMA is required, then telecalling a prospective customer only if he has desired for dealing with the bank. No misleading statements, misrepresentation permitted. Observe telemarketing etiquettes. No gifts or briberies, especially when selling loan products. Necessary precautions to be taken during the personal visits. No mis-selling. And needless to say that DSA or DMA must be appropriately dressed of either of the gender. Here in this slide, I would like to mention few points. Never ever try to mis-sell the products. What we mean by the mis-sell, many a times in order to have so much enthusiasm in selling the products, we are misleading the customer. We are target-oriented. We may be having a stress of the targets, but you have to be very, very honest as far as the customer is concerned. Basically, you may be knowing that the RBI right now is taking a very adverse view in case if any such incidents of mis-selling is reported to them. It will not be good for your bank. It not be good for you. And may be possible that a stream of customer you will be losing by this way. Same way, in the case of the telemarketing, in case any one of you is involved in that process, it will not be taking much time for you to understand whether the customer on the other side, he want to continue with the discussions or not. In case if he is not going to continue with the discussions, please apologize and withdraw yourself. So these are the few things which is very, very important. And maybe possible whenever you are visiting, you may come across then the people, they are trying to buy you by offering some bribes or gifts. So that is speaking basically about the character of the customer. And in case if you are coming across such a customers, my suggestion to all of you, being all of you very young, please avoid all these things. There may be some temptation many a times. It is a human nature. Plus, please avoid such temptations. Now, let me talk about something what as a DSA or DMA we are required to know. One thing is very, very important, and that is about the product. These are the four P's in the marketing. There are seven P's, but we'll be sticking today's discussions only on four P's: product, price, place, and promotion. And when we are talking about the customers, we must know what is the need and the wants of the customer. That is very, very important. How much it will be costing to the customer, we should be very honest. How the convenience you can provide and what the communication way a customer is seeking. So in case, because customers' needs and want in detail, I'll be discussing you in my following slide. This is very important. Same way among the four P's, the product and the price, I'll be discussing in detail keeping in view basically the products of the small finance bank, which is Surya De Small Finance Bank products, we will be discussing in detail, and what is required to be kept in mind that I will be sharing with you. So why marketing? This is something which I need not to tell you. It is a process by which a product or service is introduced by the bank and promoted to potential as well as existing customers. The heart of bank business lies in the marketing. The most aspects business depends on the successful marketing. So when you are going for sale, so it is in your hand that whatever the products the bank has brought, how much you understand that and how much you are able to convert into the business. So marketing strategy from the point of view of the customer target group is like this. Target your customer. When you are targeting your customer, you must know what type of the customer you have to target. Looking to the approach of your bank, mainly you are offering MSME, you are feeding MSME customers and you are feeding the retail customers. When you are feeding the MSME customers, that is ranging from up to 50 lakh of rupees, and they may be individual customers, they may be joint customers, they may be proprietorship firms, they may be partnership firms, there may be a partnership limited liability companies, there may be a private limited companies also. And when we are feeding to the retail customer, mostly it will be individual customer or the joint customers. Maybe some other type of the customers also, but most of the customers which will be falling in this category, that will be the individual customers and the joint customers. So now, when we are talking about the customer needs and wants and how to it assessment, this is very, very important. Whenever we are talking about the loan, when we are giving a loan to the customer, what is the purpose? What is the need? So broadly in India, we are converting these needs into two parts. One is the productive purpose and other is the consumption purpose. And there is a lot of a very big difference between the two. Whenever we are giving the productive purpose loans, at that point of time, asset which is taken by the customer or borrowed by the customer, he has to use that asset, generate the sufficient income, and from that asset only he will be repaying our loan. So whenever we are offering any loan for the business purpose, we must be very confirmed about this aspect that he is having the potential to generate the sufficient income or the funds which can be used for the recovery of the bank loan. Same way, whenever we are meeting a person for the consumption loan, like home loans, like personal car loans, etc. So in that case, he will not be using that asset, yeah, that car or that house for generating the income. That will be for the consumption purpose. In such cases, what we have to look into at first hand, as per his present status, as per his present income, whether he will be in position to repay the loan or not, whether the income is sufficient, how much dependence he is having, what is his qualification, what is his age. For example, in case if you are going to sell a housing loan to a person of 50 years or 60 years, so then you always have to keep in mind that your products may be available to such a customers up to the age of 60 or maybe 65, or in certain banks they are offering up to 70 also. So loans, housing loans, they are normally given for 20 years. So in such cases, please ensure that the remaining age of the person is adequate to meet your requirement. If not, then also please ensure whether there can be any co-borrower who can take care of this aspect. So at first hand, you will be meeting with all these things. When we are moving to the MSME customers, so we must be aware of, when we are talking about the MSME, So that means we are talking about three categories of the segments. One is micro, other is small, and third is medium. As per the existing guidelines, anyone, those who are in the manufacturing, their investment in plant and machinery, if it is up to 25 lakhs, then it will be falling under micro. If it's 25 lakh to 5 crore, it will be falling within small enterprise. If it is 5 to 10 crores, it will be falling within the medium enterprise. If someone is in services or in the trading, then the investment in equipments for the micro, it will be 10 lakh. For small, it will be 10 lakh to 2 crores. And for medium, it is 2 to 5 crores. There is a bill in discussion. So far, it has not been implemented. There, this definition may be going to change. But right now, you have to follow this. So when you will be going to the MSME and particularly the manufacturing of the services, in this slide, I want to basically have a thrust on that you will be giving them the loan for the purpose of creating the fixed assets, or you will be giving them the loan for the purpose of working capital requirements. When we are talking about the fixed assets, it may be furniture and fixture which is required. It may be any instrument which he is requiring for his working in the form of the fixed assets. It can be any equipment. It can be building. It can be commercial vehicle, any sort of things which is required by a manufacturing company, right? So in such cases, there are banks guidelines, specific guidelines, how much amount we can basically finance and how much margin a customer is required to have and what will be the pricing. All this aspect should be known to you. So when we are talking about the working capital, in the case of the working capital, there is a component of the current assets. When you will be going through the balance sheet analysis, and in case if you have seen the balance sheets, you will be finding broadly there are two components in the balance sheet. One component is the liability and other component is the assets. We are financing the assets. The whole balance sheet can be divided into four parts. Now, the liability side, first part will be long-term sources, which includes the capital, which includes the reserves, and which includes the long-term loans, which are not repayable within the 1 year. That means within the 12 months. And all other liabilities will be falling as a current liability. Same way, in the case of the assets, we are bifurcating in two parts, dividing in two parts. One part will be the fixed assets. All that assets will remain with the company. And then there will be current assets. Now the component of the current assets are cash, stocks, debtors, and few other items which are recoverable by the firm or the company within a period of 12 months and convertible in the cash. So all such components, they are known as the gross working capital, that is mainly cash, stock, inventory, and other current assets. Now, as a bank, we are mainly financing the inventory, that is the goods, stock, and the debtors, right? So according to the guidelines of your bank, you have to find out how much money you can give for the working capital. These loans are normally secured loans. Basically, the security of the stock and the book debts we are having. Now, coming to what is retail banking? Retail banking is basically a banking which is given at the mass level. And when the lot of people, when we banks are catering to the requirement for a small amount, so then we say this is a retail banking. When there are very few people and but the amount is lump sum or very high, then it is known as the corporate banking. Normally, our bank, which is a small finance bank, it is dealing with retail banking. What are the factors which are leading to the growth of retail banking in a country like India, having a population 130 crores there is a changing demographic. Most of the young people are there. Technology advancement, rapidly technology is taking place. As the Shashank will be sharing with you his own product after this. So then you will come to know. Normally in such cases, it has been observed that the NPS, they are lower. And there is a lot of deposits at the other liquidity with the banking system. So as such, we can afford to give more and more small loans instead of giving the big loans. You might have seen very recently, I don't know whether it will be appropriate to share with you or not. We have seen in the case of the PMC bank, the failure was that basically one big client, he failed, the whole bank was collapsed. So it is in our own interest in case if we are going for the small loans, small ticket loans, and then we are having a lot of retail customers. Now, marketing strategy, know your products. When we are talking to know your product, you must know basically what type of the products you are having, you are offering. So from your website, I have seen there are home loans. These are meant for the borrowers who want to purchase or self-construction of their property. Loan to value of 90% for loans amount up to rupees 30 lakhs in case if someone want to take a loan of 30 lakhs, and loan to value means what will be the value of total property and what will be the value of the loan. In case if it is a 30 lakh and say the value of the property is 35 lakhs, so 30 divided by 35 will be loan to value, which is known as LV, LTV. This is known as in short LTV. So same way, and loan value of 80% for loan amounts above rupees 30 lakhs. That means if someone want to take a loan up to 30 lakhs, or if the value of the property is up to 30 lakhs, so then the you will be insisting for a margin of only 10%. And in case if the loan value is more than 30 lakhs, then you will be asking for a margin from the borrower as a 20%. So repayment is 20 years and top up facility and refinance facility is also available. What is the meaning of the top up facility? Top up facility means someone has taken a 20 lakhs of rupees as a loan, and after some time he has been able to pay 10 lakhs, and as such now the principal amount is 20 lakh. So in such case, he is eligible for another 10 lakh. That is top up in case if all other terms and conditions remain the same. Same way in the case of the refinance facility is also available. There is a scheme of your bank for the overdraft, secured and unsecured both. Now, this is basically a facility which we are never giving to the retail for the consumption purpose. This always we are giving for the business purpose. Now, when we are talking about the business purpose, in the case of the business needs, now business need may be for the, as I have told you, in the case of the balance sheet analysis, there may be a requirement of the equipments, there may be requirement of land and building, there may be requirement of shop, there may be requirement of furniture and fixture, there may be requirement of electrical equipments, there may be a requirement of working capital finance, which is the current assets. And there may be a certain professionals who will be requiring, like doctors, like engineers. Then there will be a sole proprietor firms. There will be a partnership firms. There will be private limited companies, or there will be liability limited partnership companies also. So this is a loan which is meant for them. And what is the purpose? The purpose is overdraft facilities available in regular or drop line form. And will be either secured by collateral in the form of immovable property or commercial vehicle or unsecured nature. Now, what is the meaning of the drop line or the regular? For example, in case if I have given the 5 lakh of rupees to someone, and right now he may be in need of 5 lakh. And when I am assessing his requirement, I find next year he may not be requiring 5 lakhs. So then this limit will be 4 lakh. Then this limit will be 3 lakhs after 1 year. There after 3 years, it will be 2 lakhs. After 4 years, it will be 1 lakh. And after 5 years, it is required to be repaid in total. So in this way, both it can be drop in, it can be regular also, drop line. So all you have to check when you are dealing with the customer, that you can have this leverage, but at the same time, you have to take in the interest of the bank also in mind. And while dealing with the customer, customer unnecessary should not take any money which he is not requiring. This type of the securities should be given to very high quality customers. And if it is not, then it should be secured by some collateral. Preferable collaterals, they are the immovable properties, but even if there are the commercial vehicles or any others unsecured in nature, that also can work. So benefits, this benefits, in case if you want to have a detail of that, you please visit the terms and condition, the policy of the bank for this particular product, since it was very difficult to cover all that aspects in this slide. So I have not covered all that. So you must be in position to know what are the benefits, what is the rate of interest which you are going to offer to the customer for this purpose, what is your discretion. And when we are talking about any such benefits, please understand, these are the products which has been approved by your highest authority. As such, you will not be having any discretion. Please note, I repeat, as such, you will not be having any discretion to change any of the terms and condition unless specifically has been allowed to you. So from your side, there should not be any commitment which is not available to you. This is very, very important in such cases. When we are talking about the commercial vehicles, this is again a very, very important segment. Most of the small finance banks, they are involved in this. This can be the bus service providers, this can be the good carriers, this can be chemical transporters, this can be vehicle transporters, this can be any sort of issue. So it all depends upon in which area you are operating. In that area, what type of the customers you are having among the one which has been rated. So then, purpose of this loan is to meet the business requirement. Business requirement means the purchasing the different vehicles. So when we are talking about different vehicles, we will be doing, keeping some margin, covering some margin from the customer, and the balance amount will be giving. Prior to that, you should be in position. This is another thing which why I wanted to highlight with all of you. Then whenever you are going, you should be very thorough about one thing is known as the projections. That in case, say, you are offering a loan up to say 10 lakhs of rupees to someone, or maybe 15 lakhs or maybe 20 lakhs. Now, as per your scheme, the maximum repayment period is 60 months, that is 5 years. So if it is a 20 lakhs, so if it is a 20 lakh, that means 4 lakh per year he has to repay. So in your mind, there should be a calculation. 4 lakhs in 1 month, in 1 year, that amounts to something 30,000 plus per month, plus interest on that. So whether after using this vehicle, whether he will be in a position to repay this amount or not, whatever the EMI you will be fixing for that. So in case if you are very confident that yes, he is having the potential, he is having order. I give you one simple example. Say someone is having a tie up with the mother dairy or Amul dairy, and they are having a milk tanker, right? And this and they are transporting the milk on the regular basis, on the daily basis. And for that, as per the agreement, that you have to inquire from him that how much the agreement is there, how much amount they will be giving. In case if you find that yes, the amount which he'll be getting from the mother dairy or from the Amul or from any such other agencies, that will be sufficient to take care of his own expenses for the maintenance of the vehicle and the repayment of the loan, only then you should consider. Otherwise, accordingly, you should withdraw yourself. So benefits, again, I will request you that these are a customized financing solutions with the simple documentation and easy processing. You please go through all such benefits in detail before you are approaching to the customer. Then we are moving to loan against properties. So now this is a product which is highly in demand. This is considered to be a very secured product, basically because once you are having a property, so as against that, but this is a loan which is to be given again for the business purpose, not for the consumption purpose. This product is aimed at applicants at the bottom of the pyramid with key business like small shops, traders, retail stores, small financing units, garage, service establishments, employees with cash salary, etc. Why? It is basically because most of the money which a person or a company is having, they have invested in creating the fixed assets, and they may not be having the money for the day-to-day requirement, that is the working capital. For that purpose, we are coming to their need and we are giving the loan to them. So loan against residential commercial property to meet business needs, expansion, renovation, improvement of shop, house office, acquisition, equipments, and the personal finance, higher studies or marriages. In a very limited cases, the consumption loan can be considered, but such a products are mainly for the purpose of the business loans. Key feature, loan value 10 lakhs, repayment 60 months, minimum documentation and fast processing. So you must be having in mind what type of the documents you have to obtain. Please also keep in mind that whenever you are asking for the documents, don't ask in the piecemeals, because all the times customer will be basically irritated with these things, and time and again he will be feeling frustrated. So turn around time, which is short known as TMT, you must be having this abbreviation heard many a times. That is when you are making a promise to the customer and how fast you are in position to convert that request into the repayment disbursement, that is the turnaround time. So turnaround time can be very fast only if you understand the requirement of the customer well, you are in position to collect all the documentations in one go, then you are basically handing over that documents and the request to the processing cells very fast. So your job will be over, right? So that at least you should be doing a great favor to your bank in case if you are sticking to these things. Next is small business loans. This is the another product, retail product, business product which you are offering. And ideal for small business like kirana shops, grocery shops. Here the amount is 5 lakhs for the proprietorship concerns, and it is for the single owner enterprise. Again, there is a lot of scope for this also, and this is for meeting the working capital requirement. Now, and stock purchase, meeting sudden spike in the demand during the festive seasons and business expansion or renovation of the premises, right? Then we are moving to, this is another product where which your bank is offering, that is the joint liability group loans. In the joint liability group loans are offered to a group of women with an age group of 21 to 62 years who has an income generating activity, right? So here there is a loan amount. According to the loan, there is a tenor, and according to the tenor, there is a rate of interest. You will ask why the rate of interest in such cases are very high. Basically because these are the loans which are unsecured and having a high risk also. Normally in the banking, we are working with one phenomena that where the risk is high, the pricing will be also very high. So it is from that point of view that it has been done. So these are all about the products, and then there are certain views on the direct sales promotion in retail banking. It can be personal selling, as all of you may be knowing. There are two approaches of personal selling, product-based approach and customer-based approach. And telemarketing, 40 to 50% of the credit cards and up to 25% of the retail loans are sold through telemarketing. There may be negative reactions from the customer, as I told you in the beginning. Then you have to adjust yourself to all these things whenever you are doing the telemarketing. And then there will be a direct mail and direct response advertisements. Then marketing strategy, you must know what are your delivery channels. I have seen on the website of your bank, there are a lot of delivery channels. Branch banking is there, ATM is there, internet banking is there, mobile and phone banking is there, electronic fund transfers from point of sales. So branch banking, I need not to tell anything on this. All of you are aware about this, and ATMs you are aware. And with this, I will be concluding my PPT. And we'll request you to raise any questions if you are having. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for taking us through, you know, such elaborative description on the subject. It was very informative from all the aspects of that part. And taking the session forward quickly, I would, you know, just now like to share the second part of this presentation, which is, you know, I'd like to cover in very brief, is basically on how FinTechs can help you, you know, as sales guys or as teams over there, to approach the market with a quick preparation on the customer, I would say, and also with a quick, you know, understanding of the customer's behavior from that moment. So this is very important, you know, since now these technologies are readily available in the market, these can be harnessed, you know, certainly by the team. So quickly moving forward, you know, I'd like to share the approaches with you. What fintechs are basically doing, you know, in this particular space, they are consolidating a lot of data. Now, as sir also rightly said, that you need to have some kind of preparation, you know, before you are approaching the customer with respect to what type of a customer he or she is, you know, what type of a business, or if it's a salaried individual, what type of a profile he is carrying out. Basis on that, you will get to know there are various amounts of data which are available in the public domain today. And a lot of fintech companies have also made their products around these particular platforms. Now, very few instances which I'll quickly like to share is basically on the social profiling of an applicant, which is very must these days. Now, you may be going towards, you know, a meeting a customer, maybe for a business loan or for a retail loan or for any of the, you know, products which your institution is offering. From that aspect, now that today I know that I will be meeting this customer. So what is that you can study about that customer before you visit, before you have access to any of the data points of the customer, is basically you can quickly use certain products which tells you about the social aspect of that customer, which profiles him, what type of industry he belongs to, what type of an average income group he belongs to. A very quick example here, which I would like to give you, is basically that, you know, there are some companies who have started products like heat targets and heat mapping of the areas with respect to different income groups. So for example, if your customer today is lying between an income group of 50,000 rupees to 1 lakh rupee per month, then you can have a profiling of those areas, and you can also enter filters like which area is he residing into. Now your city will be mapped accordingly. You can just enter the profile of the customer and you will get to know that area in which he resides. What is the average income of that area? What are the type of people who are residing in that area? So you will get to know a lot about of the neighborhood of the customer as well. So you can be well prepared before you go for the meeting, and you know what to pitch and what not to pitch in that particular area. Another aspect which I wanted to cover is basically on, you can certainly have a check on the legal background of the customers, and also if there is any negative news on the applicant. Now, ways to check this is that one of the ways, as a company, Scoreme is also providing these service offerings, where you know you can have a detailed legal background check of a company with respect to any cases which have been filed by the customer or any cases which have been filed on the customer. And now, a detailed description of this can be covered in the in a quick span of 5 to 10 minutes. Now, this can be done for a salaried individual, this can be done for a partnership concern, or for any individual for that matter. Now, because the government has digitized the data from that node, so it's very easy for us to, you know, map the entire data and give it to you in a consolidated way. Now, there can be a second check, which can be with respect to, you know, if you reach out towards a private limited company. So I would say, or, you know, even if it is a retail individual, you can also check on the default list which are available in the industry. Now, there were times when these lists were available on different platforms and everybody was not having an access to these particular lists. So what nowadays the companies are doing is they are basically writing their algorithms which can collate the information from all these websites, and it can store that information in a single database. So that today, if you want to search for ABC company against ABC, if any of the directors has been, you know, ever disqualified, or whether there are any willful defaults being committed by ABC, or for example, if you also have to check, you know, what is the what I would say, all types of strike off default list, you can get a check on that as well. So all these default lists are also very important, which are published and updated by the government on a daily basis. You should certainly look at, and you should also look for peer comparisons in these particular lists. So for example, if today you are going and meeting a customer and one of the close competitions of that customer has been, you know, gone through that list. Now you can certainly assume that there is a higher probability of the conversion because the customer knows that the market share is decreased because of, you know, that customer falling into negative list. So these are various types of checks which you can do on your customers before you try and visit them. And also there is basically, you know, processes which are on digital onboarding of the customer, which saves a lot of time and, you know, what I would say, effort of the sales team. Now there were days where you had to do multiple follow-ups with the customers for the documents, to study them forward and then to forward them to the credit team. But nowadays there are applications which are being made, which are like a complete digital journey. The applicant, if you know, you are visiting their office or their household, or if they want to apply directly with you over a phone call, that is possible. So the entire application journey has also been digitized by a lot of fintechs. Now we as a company, we do provide one such solution where your application can entirely be digitized, and it can directly reach out to the credit team for a quicker decision on that customer. So these are basically few of the applications which I wanted to share from the fintech perspective, that you need to do social profiling of your customers. You need to study any negative data which is available regarding to your customer in with respect to, you know, all the legal backgrounds in the country. You should check for any negative news which is there on the customer. Also, you know, you should try and develop some digital platforms internally so that, you know, you are able to onboard that customer. So with this, I would, you know, like to end the subject presentation here, and we would like to move forward for a Q&A round. So you can post your questions in the Q&A section, and me and Rajesh sir will be available for addressing any of those questions. You can direct them or you can generalize the questions as well. And
well, Shushank, I have received three questions.
Okay.
First question is fixed obligation to income ratio. Calculation is completely reliable? I will say yes, provided the person who is giving to you is giving you the correct data. Because any information which is given to you by the customer, you should please go through that information and try to realize yourself also whether it can be correct or not. And in case you find it is not correct, then it cannot be reliable. In case if you find, for example, say someone, as I given you one example of 20 lakh of rupees a loan you are giving for purchase of bus, and person is not having any tie-up with any of the company, then in case if he is giving you the projection, so unless you are not satisfied that how he will be doing that, you should not accept this. The second question is by Mr. Rohan Nanda. is the current scenario of COVID, is there possibility of change in MSME definition? To my mind, I don't have any answer for this. It is basically up to the government to decide. I don't think that by way of the definition, any change will come. But as far as the RBI is concerned, they may be giving certain relaxations. As far as the repayment of the loan is concerned, looking into the stress which this sector is facing. So from the RBI side, I feel there will be certain relaxations, including the NPA norms. But as far as the definition is concerned, which is to be decided by the government of India, about that I am not sure. Third thing is, as turnover can take a major hit now, definitely yes. Definitely yes. So even if the things will become regular, so there is an issue of the raw material purchase. There is an issue of the semi-skilled labor or maybe a casual labor. There may be issues. So as such, looking to that aspects, there may be a hit. And there is one more question. What is the reason behind not offering a customer with multiple working capital facilities, OD or CC in general by banks? I'm not very clear about what is the meaning of the question, because all the banks, to my knowledge, they're offering the working capital limits. What is the meaning of the multiple working capital and what is the need of the multiple working capital? I'm not very sure. Because as far as the working capital is concerned, banks, they are catering the need of building the stock. And in case if the companies, they are selling the goods on the credit and then for financing their debtors till the realization is coming from them. So as such, there has to be a single working capital requirement. There cannot be a multiple working capital requirement, right? So in case if the question can be more clear, so I can answer according to that. I don't find any other questions.
Sir, there are more questions after this. So basically it says that.
Okay. One minute. Let me. Yes, there are questions. 1 minute. There is Sunil. Is the present scenario of uncertainty how to ensure serviceability of loan over its life? Whenever such uncertainties are concerned, there is no surety about the serviceability, and that is why I just share with you that there is every possibility that there may be extension of the NPA norms, which right now is 90 days on most of the banks. For next 3 months, and they have already declared that they cannot insist for the repayment of the loans. So this is all looking into that, since there is a stress on the serviceability of the loan. So that is already there. But in the normal circumstances, whenever we are doing the assessment, there should not be any issue to contrary to ensuring that the serviceability of the loan will not be there over its life. Unless it is not there, so we will not be sanctioning the loan and there will not be any viability. So next question is LAP case end use mandatory? Yes. In all the cases, end use is mandatory. To ensure the end use, it is mandatory. How is FinTech different from CIBIL checks?
I can take this question, sir.
Yes, just I give you one point on the CIBIL and FinTech. You can take, definitely there is a lot of difference. CIBIL is collecting the data of the retail loans from the various banks, those who are the member of the CIBIL, and based on that, they are providing you the credit score based on the behavior of the repayment of the borrowers. So whereas the fintech company, Shashank will be telling you what is their major roles.
So it's very rightly said, sir. So I will just, you know, as a layman, you can have this knowledge that CIBIL is basically the entire information on the historical data of the customer. It has nothing to do with the, you know, the live data where the customer is currently operating at. But it certainly gives you a very good idea as to what has or how has the customer served his earlier loans or any types of borrowings or credit cards which he has taken. Now, from that note, you can get to know what is the repayment capacity or how is the repayment capacity of the customer. But using fintech applications will enable you to basically judge the customer on parameters which are not available in your CIBIL output reports. A few parameters which I've explained in the presentation. Plus, there can be, if you get an access to the financial data of the customer, for example, the bank statements or the ITRs, then the fintech offerings can be a whole lot different for you, where you can get a complete accessibility of the customer with respect to where he is standing today, not that how he has served in the historical years. So this is the major difference, that FinTech works on a real-time databases and CIBIL works on the historical database.
Next question is from Sunil. In current scenario where cost of borrowing is to be reduced, can the banks allow to raise the through CP against sanction of working capital with the condition that MPBF will reduce once funds are received in account and to that extent? First of all, CP is a money market product. And at the same time, it is a prerogative of the borrower to go to the money market and raise the fund. And as far as reduction or earmarking of the MPBF is concerned, this is always there. Whenever anyone is raising CP from the money market and informing the bank, to that extent, MPBF is reduced. Otherwise, it will be amounting to the double financing, which cannot be allowed, right? So it is a prerogative of the borrower, and it is no question whether the banks allow or not allow. Only Sunil, you may be knowing that any person who is going to the money market will be highly rated customer, and highly rated customer normally they are not dependent on the banks, and lot of banks they are after them. So as such, I don't think that bank allow or not allow will be making any difference. Next question is from Pooja. Any change in loan percentage interest in case NPA is low? Any changes in loan percentage interest in case is NPA is low? I am not very clear about this question. What, Pooja, you want to ask? I am not aware.
Pooja, you can
I am not getting the question actually.
So Pooja, you can mail us a question and we can
Please, you can mail exactly by some case in case if you can mail the question. So, and then how is the assessment of income is different from LAP loan to home loan, whereas income remain currently for future loan repayment? How is the assessment of income is different from LAP loan to home loan? Again, I am not very clear about this question. What exactly is the meaning? What is asked by, I don't know. Badrinath, PN. Most of participants in the sessions are direct employees of the bank handling the sales activity. Your advice is to DSA MDA would apply for our employees. Of course, these are the general views which was expressed. This is not bank specific. Bank specific was only banking product. More or less, I have seen in this sector, the products are also same. May be possible that few maximum loan amount or interest rate may be a different looking to the competition. Otherwise, it is applicable. Next is income remains same. What is the meaning of
income? Question was left incomplete, sir.
I think. In future, we will be talking balance transfer case. So 3 months EMI effect and consume.
Again, the question is, team, I would request if you can just, you know, whatever questions you're not able to address, you can mail it directly to me. I can, you know, get them addressed.
No issue. What basically you want to ask by way of a illustration, in case if you will ask, that will be making things very clear. Does the moratorium declared by RBI actually help a commercial vehicle loan clientele? Definitely, yes. They are the sector segment which is affected very badly. So since there is a lockdown and no movement of the commercial vehicle is there, so they will not be having any income. So definitely it will be applicable to them also. How the market will behave after current market scenario due to COVID, as most of the financial products are connected to micro and microeconomic. Very, very difficult to say, but it will take some time to get the things in the regular form. And very difficult to say by any economist or by the banker how the markets will be behaving. I feel that the physical deficit will increase the way the government is announcing the various measures to take care of this particular situation. So difficult, right, to say. Sir, my point was that, Sunil, while earmarking the limits for issuing CP, the limits are reduced from the date of sanction and for amount of earmarked limits, and not from the date of amount is received. Well, that is something you can sort out with the customer. According to me and as per the practice which I was following, it will be always from the date of receiving the amount, not from the date of sanction. So date of sanction is one thing. After the date of sanction, there is a lot of work which is done, documentations are done, and then the payment will be released by the treasury, and only then the amount will be coming to you. The moment amount is coming to you, you can state a earmark and allow. Abhijit Singh, what will be LTV on secured OD? In the case of the secured OD, LTVs are always given by way of the demand loan or term loan, not by way of the overdraft, right? So this is not applicable to the OD. Cash salaried customer is eligible for LAP loan. According to me, LAP loans, they are for the business purpose and they are not for the salaried purpose. I don't have much idea about your bank, and this question I think should be addressed by someone internally from the bank only. Looking to the current scenario, what could be the top 5 priority MSME sectors for lending going forward now? All the 5 top priorities are, fundamentally it should be strong, satisfactory track record, and customer is having good CIBIL score. These are the fundamental lending going forward now to be on a very safer side. And on the top of that, in case if someone is offering some collateral security which is well taking care of the loan amount, that should also be encouraged without saying. In case CIBIL reflected loans, some loan are belongs to CM, some not, then how to get the? Again, this question is incomplete.
We can move towards the next questions that I'll try to address this. I think most of the questions now are coming towards what is the market scenario.
Yeah, like right. Loan is visible in customer CIBIL, but he is saying that the loan is not belonging to me. In that case, what we'll do? I think Shishank can address this question, but out of my own experience, in such cases, there is a name of the bank also in the CIBIL where the default has taken place. In case if the customer can contact that bank and from that he removed his name from the CIBIL data, so that can serve the purpose.
Yes, absolutely. And I think in this case, there can be certain entries within the CIBIL database.
Maybe possible. Many a times what is happening in the case of the credit card, there are charges. Someone is not using the credit card, but there are charges of the credit card, and due to that, it is shown as default. So in such cases, basically, if such a case is there, so bank, they are taking a considerable view and removing the name. How to affect working capital to open market after lockdown? How to affect working capital to open market? What is this question? I don't understand.
So I think,
there is no more questions. Correct. So as such, we can call it a day. I'll be sharing the PPT. Someone has asked whether we'll be sharing the PPT. I'll be sharing the PPT, Shashank, with you. Correct. And you can forward to the participants. And all the participants, they are welcome with their individual questions to either of us, and we'll be too happy to address the same.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for taking this topic. And thank you for all the attendees to attend this webinar from that note. I think it was a very informative session. So we discussed on various aspects related to marketing of the different types of products into retail and MSME loans. And also we discussed on, you know, what are do's and don'ts for the sales team of the bank while they are approaching the customers. We also focused a short while on the FinTechs, which are basically enabling the sales team to gather more information around the customers. So overall, I would say it was a very informative session, sir. Thank you so much for your presence here. And we would like to have any amount of questions which you guys want to forward. You can always share it on my email ID, or you have Pratik's email ID with you. You can address to Pratik as well. So with this note, thank you, everybody. Very good evening to all. Stay safe, stay indoors, and we'll be ending the session now. Thank you.